Hello everyone, thank you for joining the webinar. This webinar will be on online career guidance program on speech and hearing. And this is particularly focused on what you can do after second PU. If you are going through second PU or you have finished second PU, and for the parents also. So I'll be talking about what we exactly do in speech and hearing, and about the speech and hearing course itself, about the JS Institute of Speech and Hearing. And finally, you can always ask questions. Of whatever questions you might have. So let's start. Selecting the right course is very, very important. Know that after second PU, most of us, but there are a lot of other courses also. Because in a particular course, you will be spending 4 years, 5 years like this. After that, you have to do a job, okay, which is similar to the course that you have. So it's very important that you select a course which is dependent on your. A course where you can land a useful job. Okay. So this is a very competitive world, and the jobs that we choose are very important. And of course, that is dependent on the course that we take. Okay. So in terms of time and in terms of a financial investment, the course that we do is very, very important. So what do we do in speech and hearing? What is the speech and hearing course? So as you see, there are two parts to it, speech. Speech is to do with speech production, how speech is produced, how speech is understood, how can you understand what, how does a child learn speech? What are the different things that can go wrong in learning speech, in understanding speech? At different ages, okay, whether it can be at the level of a child, okay, at a level of an adult, or in an old person, okay. We'll learn in speech how to analyze, how to assess, okay, what are the different problems people are facing, and how we treat it. So, examples you might have heard of stuttering, right? I have this problem. So those who repeat things, yes. So we learn to analyze and treat those people. You might have heard of autism. These children have poor social development. Okay, they don't make eye contact. They don't mix with other children. Okay, they don't develop speech all that well like this. You might have heard of learning disability. So these people, these children have poor academic records. Okay, so they will reverse whatever, B instead of D, D instead of B, like this. They might also have behavioral problems. So everybody would have seen Tari Zameen Par, right? So that's a good example of learning disability. And you might have come across people with stroke. Some of these people might understand what you are saying, but they cannot talk to you. And some others might not really understand what you are telling them, but can talk fluently. So we'll learn to treat all these kind of people. Hearing wise, we refer to this field as audiology. So we learn to see how we can hear the softest of the sounds to the loudest of the sounds, how we can understand speech, how you are understanding me over internet right now, how there is a lot of noise around you, but you can still understand what I'm saying. Even though you're not really paying attention to it, right? And what are the things that can go wrong? Okay. So for example, there are many children who don't hear at all right from birth. Okay. So these children, if we don't treat them, if we don't manage them, they'll not develop speech at all. Okay. So there are newborn hearing screening programs where audiologists go to the hospital and within a week after birth, we assess them and see if they have hearing loss or not. Or hearing loss can develop later. The child is developing normally, but for some reason, there's a very high fever. And after that, hearing is totally lost. Again, this will affect speech and language development. Or it might be in an adult. Okay. Or everybody knows that as age progresses, there is hearing loss, right? So you might have come across your parents, okay, your grandparents who have problem hearing, okay, who increase the TV volume, right? So everybody knows this. So we can assess all those people and treat them. So audiology as a branch, we work with ENT professionals, okay, to treat medical disorders. So you have an ear infection, ear pain, discharge from the ear. Okay. So we work with the ENT and they prescribe medicines. And a lot of times medicines don't help because there's no infection. There is a hearing loss. For them, we hit them with hearing aids. Okay. And we work with a surgical team to implant a cochlear implant inside the ear for those with more severe disorders. So this is what we do in speech and hearing. So by now you would have got some idea. We don't work alone. It's a multidisciplinary setup. We work with the ENT professionals. We work with psychologists. We work with pediatricians, neurologists, engineers, statisticians, okay, like this. So in a medical setup especially, we have a lot of referrals and we talk to a lot of other doctors also. And of course, we cannot forget school teachers because children are a very important part of treatment in our field. So the course itself, the starting course is BSc in audiology and speech language pathology. So ASLP or BSc in speech. So you can have PCM or PCB background. PCB is preferred because biology is and the minimum score, the eligibility is. So this time around, there will be no entrance test based purely on merit, and the minimum cutoff, okay, in your board exams should be 50%. The duration of the course itself, it's 3 years divided into 6 of intention. So these 3 years, what do we do? Typically, you will have afternoon postings in the hospital or in the lab. And in the morning, you'll have academics or the other way around. So you see that you'll be very busy. Academics plus clinics. Clinics is where you learn to treat the patients, assess the patients. And academics is where you understand the theoretical basis of all that. And in the evening, you'll have a lot of assignments also. So a lot of dedication is required for this course. And you must be willing to work with patients. This is very important, right? So this is a rehabilitative field. So you work with patients, you work with children, adults, and geriatrics. So you will spend time with the patients, understanding the communication difficulties that they have. Okay, typical pinpointing where the problem is, and treat them. So this can take over years for a treatment to be successful. And the last year is the internship where you'll be posted in and around Mysore in different clinics and hospitals. You'll be learning hands-on how to treat the patients. So you'll be working under a clinical supervisor, under an audiologist or a speech language pathologist, how to exactly do things. Because after this, you might be working outside and you'll be completely independent. So what's the curriculum that we have? So the core subject, of course, is speech language pathology. So to do something to do with speech and hearing. Along with this, we have medical subjects because we are dealing with patients, right? Otolaryngology, neurology, and there are allied subjects. We don't go in depth into these, but we have a background in all these subjects. Clinical psychology, linguistics and phonetics, acoustics and electronics, computer science and instrumentation, statistics and research methods, Indian constitution, speech and drama, and community-based rehabilitation. Okay. So after finishing the course, where can you work? What are the different opportunities that you have? So the important part here is that nearly 12% of the Indian population, so we are 1 billion, right? So 12% of the Indian population have speech and hearing problems. To manage this, we don't have as many speech language pathologists and audiologists. Okay, so there is a great demand within the country. So if you are dedicated, a job is not a problem. The opportunities are a lot. Okay, and nearly 20% of our students work abroad. So even abroad, there are a lot of opportunities. Okay. Just that you have to be interested and dedicated. So where can you work? You can work in hospitals, okay, where you'll be working with a lot of you can work in child rehabilitation centers, industrial setups. So you know that if there is noise exposure, if you hear a loud sounds, okay, there can be hearing loss. Those who work in factories, they are typically on a daily basis, they are exposed to loud sounds. So they might have hearing loss. So audiologists can be based in you can work in normal schools, okay, and special schools, rehabilitative units. And you can also opt for a private practice. You can open your own clinic and deal with the patients. So this is a clinical setup, or you can also work in a research setup. It's a lab, okay, where you do constant research, investigating how best, what test is the best to understand the difficulties of how best to treat the patient. Research is very, very important in any field. Also in the rehabilitative field. And finally, you can choose academics. That is, you can go for higher studies, MSc. Okay. So when you go to MSc, you have a choice of MSc in audiology, MSc in speech language pathology, or a combination of both. Okay, MSc in speech and hearing. Okay. Or you can teach. Okay, you can teach the students. And whenever you are in academic setup, you not only teach the students, you also treat the patients. So because you have to teach the students how to treat the patients, so you also have a clinical setup within academics, and also you have a research setup. So academics is teaching plus research plus clinics. So there are no problems with the opportunities at all. In fact, it's for you to utilize whatever. So this is speech and hearing itself was established by and we are affiliated to the University of Mysore, and the Rehabilitation Council of India, which is the premier council to do with the rehabilitation courses within India. We offer BSc in speech and hearing. Afterwards, you have a specialization, the master's, as well as the doctor. So BSc in speech and hearing was the one we started the earliest. Most recently, we have the specialization. Okay, this is important because a lot of students felt that they would want to specialize in one field rather than speech and hearing as a whole, in speech only. And to meet with that demand, that we recently started. And academic activities. So we teach the students, okay, the theory part, clinical activities, the practical part. How to test the patients, how to understand their problems, and how to treat the patients. Research activities, how to constantly prepare ourselves. And finally, public education programs. We give a lot of importance to public. Public education program is where we reach out to the public, create awareness with respect to hearing loss. For example, burning of crackers during Deepavali, Autism Day, Learning Disability Day. And these are typically done in the form of cyclothons, rallies, street plays like this. So we place a lot of importance on the public education programs and the extracurricular activities. And you might have heard of this very famous Suttur Jatre. So this is where we reach out to thousands of people at a time and orient them regarding the speech and hearing problems. So our institute is well equipped with classrooms with the latest technologies, not only just the whiteboard, but also with a PowerPoint projector, which is connected to the internet. We also have a constant CCTV supervision, a very, very well equipped library and information center, clinical training and services. So we collaborate with the JSS hospital for the recommendation of cases as well as the treatment. well-equipped laboratories. So it's not enough to do deal just with the patients. So to be the most efficient at it, you must actually understand what exactly is the problem. And labs with simulation is very important for this. So that's why we have labs with a lot of software and instrumentation to make sure you understand what the problem is and how varying different parameters can affect your perception. Hostel facilities, those away from Mysore can avail this. It's very near to the institute. You can actually walk. Healthcare, all students will have an insurance card, health insurance card. Students council and cultural and sports activities. I've told you this, extracurricular activities are very much encouraged. Student welfare cells, and finally, placement cells. Once you finish the course, what are the different opportunities that you have? That's where a placement cell will guide you and help you in accessing those opportunities. And very recently, the Indian College and University rating was given by JSS Institute of Speech and Hearing rated gold. That means to say, not only just academics, also research plus clinical activities plus extracurricular activities, that the institute is top-notch at. So definitely, if you are interested in the field of speech and hearing, you have the aptitude and interest in it, and you can definitely consider the JSS Institute of Speech and Hearing as an option. So this is our detail. Please note down the phone number. 821-25 and finally our website jssish. So everything that I have told you is available online in our website. So the applications are also open there. You can download it, it up and mail it to us, or directly deliver it to us. And any other details you want, you can directly call us up. And also you can email us. Okay. We have a short video for you, how the lifestyle of a student based in our institute would look.
Dum dare, dum dare, dum dare, dum dare, dum da, dum dare, dum dare, dare, dum dum dum.
Dum dare, dum dare, dum dare, dum dare, dum da, dum dare, dum dare, dare, dum dum dum.
Kathayunda helide, bari gurutugale college ali, classroom ina bench ali, corridor wall ali. ಗೀಚಿದೆ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಶಿಪ್ ಇನ ನೆಪದಲ್ಲಿ
sounds well.
Thank you. I start speak now.
So that was a small clip on what we do and some idea about the facilities in our institute. So any questions at all that you have, they are very much welcome. It can be about the course itself, on the fee structure, or opportunities after finishing the course. Any questions at all? You are free to speak in any language.
Namaste, sir.
Hello. Hey, ma'am.
Namaste, sir. Nan Mysore inda maatadtidini. ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಈಗ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಪಿ ಯು ಸಿ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಆಗಿದೆ.
ಓಕೆ,
ಇವಾಗ 50% ಬಂದ್ರೆ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಪಿ ಯು ಸಿ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್, ಏನ್ ಫೀಸ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಆಗತ್ತೆ ಸರ್? ಮೋರ್ ದನ್ 50% ಬಂದ್ರೆ ಫೀಸ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಏನಾಗತ್ತೆ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ? ಓಬಿಸಿ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಗೆ
ಎಲಿಜಿಬಿಲಿಟಿ 50% ಅಷ್ಟೇ. 50% ಮೇಲ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು. ಅದಾದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಒಂದು ಮೆರಿಟ್ ಲಿಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ನಾವು. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೆರಿಟ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ಪರ್ ಇಯರ್ ಅರೌಂಡ್ 1.5 to 2 lakh ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ 2 semesters. ಸೊ 2 installments ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಪೇ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು.
1.5 to 2.
ಹೌದು. And namdo around we have 40 to 50 students per year intake.
Hello.
Heli sir.
ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮೀ ಸರ್, ನಾನು ತಾರಿಣಿ ಫಾದರ್ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ಇದು ಇದು ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇದು ಎಷ್ಟಿದೆ ಸರ್, ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ನಿಮ್ದ ತಗೊಳೋದು ಸೀಟ್ಸ್?
40 to 50 ಇರತ್ತೆ ಸರ್ ಪರ್ ಇಯರ್.
40 to 50 ಇರುತ್ತಾ? ಕಮೆನ್ಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಯೂಶುವಲಿ ಯಾವಾಗ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ಬೋದು?
ಅದು ಸದ್ಯಕ್ಕೆ ಇನ್ನು ಡಿಸೈಡ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ, ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಅದು ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ರೆಗ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ನೌ ಅದಿನ್ನು ಡಿಸೈಡ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ. ಇನ್ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ಓಪನ್ ಇದೆ, ಬಟ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸಿಂಗ್ ಡೇಟ್ ಇನ್ನು ಡಿಸೈಡ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ
ಇನ್ನು ಡಿಸೈಡ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ.
ಹೌದು, ಅದು ಕೋವಿಡ್ ಸಿಚುಯೇಷನ್ ಹೆಂಗಿದೆ
ಅನ್ನೋದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ. ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಯಾವಾಗ ಇದೆ? ಎಂಟ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಯಾವಾಗ ಬಿಡಬಹುದು?
ಈ ಸಲ ಎಂಟ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ಸರ್, ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್
ಎಂಟ್ರೆನ್ಸ್
ಬೋರ್ಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿನೇಷನ್.
ಬೋರ್ಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಎಂಟ್ರಿ ಆಗಿದೆ?
ಹೌದು ಹೌದು.
ಅಡ್ಮಿಷನ್, ಹೌದು ಅಡ್ಮಿಷನ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಹೇಗೆ ಆಗಿದೆ? ಈಗ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅಡ್ಮಿಷನ್ ತಗೊಳ್ತೀರಾ?
ಹಂಗಲ್ಲ, ಇವಾಗ ವಿತಿನ್, ಇವಾಗ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ಓಪನ್ ಇದೆ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಯಾವಾಗ್ಲೋ ಒಂದ್ಸಲ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಮೇಬಿ ಇನ್ 1 month ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ಅದಾದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಅದ್ರ ಬೇಸಿಸ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಮೆರಿಟ್ ಲಿಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಫಸ್ಟ್ 50 ಆ ತರ.
ಸರಿ ಸರ್, ಅದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಇದು ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ? ಓಕೆ ಸರ್. ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಈಗ ಎಲ್ಲ ಆನ್ಲೈನ್ ಸರ್ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್, ಅಥವಾ ಸಬ್ಮಿಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಾ
ಆನ್ಲೈನ್? ಹೌದು ಹೌದು, ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ಆನ್ಲೈನ್ ಇದೆ, ಅದ್ ಡೌನ್ಲೋಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಫಿಲ್ ಮಾಡಿ, ನಮಗೆ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು ಇಲ್ಲ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟಲ್ ತಂದು ಕೊಡಬಹುದು.
ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟಲ್ ಗೆ ತಂದು ಕೊಡಬಹುದು.
ಹೌದು.
ಓಕೆ, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸರ್, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು. ಫೌಂಡೇಶನ್ ಏನಂತ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಸರ್ ಇದು ಕೋರ್ಸ್?
ಇದು BASLP ಅಂತ.
BASLP ಅಂತ.
ಹಾ
ಐ ಸೀ.
ಬ್ಯಾಚುಲರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಆಡಿಯೋಲಜಿ ಇನ್ ಸ್ಪೀಚ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್ ಪ್ಯಾಥಾಲಜಿ ಅಂತ. ಬಟ್ ಇನ್ನು ಕಾಮನ್ ಆಗಿ BSc ಇನ್ ಸ್ಪೀಚ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಹಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಎಲ್ಲ ಜನಕ್ಕೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿರೋದು. ಬಟ್ ಅಫಿಷಿಯಲಿ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ BASLP.
BASLP. ಇದರ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಹೈಯರ್ ಸ್ಟಡೀಸ್ MASLP ಎಷ್ಟು ಇಯರ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಅದು?
ಅದು 2+1. ಓಕೆ, 2 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ 2 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಅಕಾಡೆಮಿಕ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಪ್ಲಸ್ 1 ಇಯರ್ ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಶಿಪ್ ತರ ಇರುತ್ತೆ.
ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಶಿಪ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸರ್, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ಸ್ ಅ ಲಾಟ್.
ಸೊ ಅದು ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಶಿಪ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಅದು ಇಯರ್ ಟು ಇಯರ್ ವೇರಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ 2 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಎಸೆನ್ಷಿಯಲಿ 2 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಅದು ಇನ್ 1 ಇಯರ್ ಕೆಲಸ ಲೆಕ್ಕನೆ ಬರುತ್ತೆ.
Hello sir, how are you?
I'm fine, ma'am.
Can you please tell me the job opportunities for this course?
So after finishing the course, you can opt for a clinical setup. Okay, so you might work in hearing aid clinics. So you might have heard of hearing aid clinics which are multinational, okay, spread throughout different countries including India. So you can opt for to work in a hearing aid clinic. Okay, or you can opt for a hospital setup. Okay, so there are openings in almost all hospitals where there is a speech language pathologist or an audiologist, so you can work there, or you can work in research labs all around India and abroad. Okay, where you specifically work on one particular topic, or you can work in schools, okay, normal schools as well as special schools where you deal with children. Or you can go for an academic setup, that is you can work with undergraduate students, okay, teach them, and academic setup will also have a clinical setup and research setup along with that. So job opportunities, there is no problem for that at all, ma'am. Almost our strike rate is nearly 100%. Anybody who wants a job and who is good at it definitely gets a job. In fact, there is a recent government recommendation that all hospitals should have a post for audiologists and speech language pathologists. So it's being implemented. As of now, it's not 100% implemented, but it's going through the process. Okay? And a lot of central government and state government institutes as well as posts are coming up, and they'll only increase with time. And all of this is because the professionals in this field are low in number relative to the number of patients that we actually have.
Okay sir, thank you, thank you very much.
Hello sir.
Yes, heli
sir, idu BSc speech and hearing antala sir course?
Haudu haudu.
ಅಂದ್ರೆ 3+1 ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನ್ ಸರ್? ಒಂದು ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಶಿಪ್ ಅದು ಒಂದು ವರ್ಷ ಏನಾದ್ರು?
ಹೌದು ಹೌದು, 3 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಕಾಲೇಜ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟಲ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಪ್ಲಸ್ 1 ಇಯರ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿಕಲ್.
ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಶಿಪ್ ಅಂತೀರಾ ನೀವು ಅಥವಾ ಇನ್ನೇನ್ ಬೇರೆ?
ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಶಿಪ್. ಓಕೆ, ಮೈಸೂರು ಸುತ್ತಮುತ್ತ ಇರೋ ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟಲ್ಸ್, ನಮ್ದೆ ಎಷ್ಟೊಂದು ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟಲ್ ಸೆಟಪ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ, ಕ್ಲಿನಿಕ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಪೋಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಅದು ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಪೇಷಂಟ್ಸ್ ಜೊತೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ಡೀಲ್ ಮಾಡಿದಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಥಿಯರಿ ಏನೂ ಇರಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಸೂಪರ್ವಿಷನ್ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಪಾಸ್ ಔಟ್ ಆದ್ಮೇಲೆ ದೇ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ಇಂಡಿಪೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ಲಿ ಅಂತ.
ಇದು ಸರ್, ಇದು ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಒಂದು ಸಾಮಾನ್ಯವಾಗಿ ಏನಂದ್ರೆ ಇಂಡಿಯಾದಲ್ಲಿ ಜಾಬ್ ಆಪರ್ಚುನಿಟೀಸ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ, ಬಟ್ ಫಾರಿನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿದೆ ಅಂತಾರೆ, ಅದೇನು ಅದ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಒಂದು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಹೇಳಿ ಸರ್.
ಹೌದು, ಇಂಡಿಯಾಲಿ ಜಾಬ್ ಆಪರ್ಚುನಿಟೀಸ್ ಕಮ್ಮಿ ಅಂತಿಲ್ಲ, ಇದೆ, ಬಟ್ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ಹೊರಗಡೆ ಫಾರಿನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ನು ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇದೆ.
ಅಲ್ಲ, ಈಗ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಯಾರೋ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಇಲ್ಲ, ನಾವು ಫಾರಿನ್ ಹೋಗ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗಲ್ಲ, ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋರ್ಗೆ ಏನಾದ್ರೂ ಅಪರ್ಚುನಿಟೀಸ್ ಇದೆಯಾ ಇಲ್ಲೂ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಜಾಬ್ ತಗೋಬೇಕು
ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲೇನಾ?
ಅಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ಲ, ನಮ್ಮ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ಅಂತಿಲ್ಲ ಸರ್, ಎನಿವೇರ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ.
ಹೌದು, ಅಲ್ಲ ಇಂಡಿಯಾಲೂ ಆಪರ್ಚುನಿಟೀಸ್ ಇದೆ, ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ಇದೆ, ಬಟ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅಬ್ರಾಡ್ ಆಪರ್ಚುನಿಟೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಮೋರ್, ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ಮೋರ್.
ಅಬ್ರಾಡ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಯಾವ್ದಾದ್ರು ನೇಮ್ ಇದ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ಸರ್, ಹೇಳಿ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಇವೆ? Which countries?
ಹೌದು ಹೌದು, ಅಂದ್ರೆ US ಮತ್ತೆ ಆಸ್ಟ್ರೇಲಿಯಾ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇದೆ.
ಹಾ ಹಾ ಹಾ, US ಆಸ್ಟ್ರೇಲಿಯಾ.
ಹೌದು.
ಆಮೇಲೆ ಇದು ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಅಂತ ಏನಾದ್ರು ಅವಾರ್ಡ್ ಇದೆಯಾ ಸರ್ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ಗೆ? ಏನಿಲ್ಲ
ಇಲ್ಲ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಬಿ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ ಎಂ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಪಿ ಎಚ್ ಡಿ ಇದೆ, ಅದಾದ್ಮೇಲೆ ನಾವು ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು, ಬಟ್ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಅಂತ ಬರಲ್ಲ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಅಲೈಡ್ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಮೆಡಿಸಿನ್ ಗೆ ಅಲೈಡ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್.
ಎಂಎಸ್ಸಿ ಎಷ್ಟು ವರ್ಷ ಸರ್ ಅದು?
ಎಂಎಸ್ಸಿ 2 ಇಯರ್ಸ್.
ಎಂಎಸ್ಸಿ 2 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಇದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ಎಂಎಸ್ಸಿ ಆಡಿಯೋಲಜಿ ಅಂತ ಅದನ್ನು ಕೋರ್ಸಸ್.
ಹೌದು, ಅದು ಎಂಎಸ್ಸಿ ಬಂದಾಗ ನಿಮ್ ಸ್ಪೆಷಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಇಲ್ಲ ಸ್ಪೀಚ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್ ಪೆಥಾಲಜಿ ಅಂತ ಹೋಗ್ಬೋದು, ಇಲ್ಲ ಆಡಿಯೋಲಜಿ ಅಂತ ಹೋಗ್ಬೋದು.
ಈ ಆನ್ಲೈನ್ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ಹಾಕ್ಬೋದಾ?
ಹೌದು, ಆನ್ಲೈನ್ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ಆನ್ಲೈನ್ ಇದೆ, ಅದ್ ಡೌನ್ಲೋಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಫಿಲ್ ಮಾಡಿ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಅಥವಾ ತಂದ್ಕೊಡ್ಬೇಕು.
ಓಕೆ ಸರ್.
ಸಬ್ಮಿಷನ್ ಆನ್ಲೈನ್ ಇಲ್ಲ.
ಸಬ್ಮಿಷನ್ ಆನ್ಲೈನ್ ಇದೆಯಾ?
ಆನ್ಲೈನ್ ಇಲ್ಲ.
ಆನ್ಲೈನ್ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ. ಹಾ, ಡೌನ್ಲೋಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಥ್ರೂ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್.
ಹೌದು ಹೌದು.
ಇದು ಫೀಸ್ 1.5 ನಾ ಸರ್ ಪರ್ ಇಯರ್?
ಪರ್ ಇಯರ್ 1.5 to 2 lakh ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಸದ್ಯಕ್ಕೆ ನನ್ಗಿರೋ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ಪ್ರಕಾರ 1,65,000 ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಕೋತಾ ಇದೀನಿ, ಬಟ್ ರೇಂಜ್ ಅದು 1.5 to 2 lakh.
ನಮ್ ಜೆ ಎಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಇದೆ ಸರ್? ಇದು ಒಟ್ಟು ಧಾರವಾಡ ಒಂದ್ ಕೇಳಿದೀನಿ, ಅಲ್ಲೊಂದ್ ಇದೆಯಾ?
ಹೌದು ಹೌದು, ಮೈಸೂರಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದಿದೆ,
ಧಾರವಾಡ.
ಏನ್ ಹೇಳಿ?
ಮೈಸೂರಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಅಂತ?
ಮೈಸೂರಲ್ಲಿ ಜೆ ಎಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟಲ್ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ, ಅರಮನೆ ತರ ಒಂದೊಡ್ಡ ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟಲ್ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ,
ಹೇಳಿ ಸರ್.
ಹಾ, ಅದ್ರ ಪಕ್ಕನೇ ಇದೆ
ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಊಟಿ ರೋಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲ?
ಹೌದು ಹೌದು, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅಗ್ರಹಾರ ಗೊತ್ತಲ್ಲ.
ಓಕೆ, ಹೌದು ಹೌದು ಸರ್.
ಹಾ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ.
ಓಕೆ, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸರ್.
ಓಕೆ. ಬೇರೆ ಇನ್ನೇನಾದ್ರೂ ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್, ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಏನಾದ್ರು ಇದೆಯಾ? ಸ್ಕಾಲರ್ಶಿಪ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಕೆಲವರು ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಕೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಬಿ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಕಾಲರ್ಶಿಪ್ ಅಂತ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಬಟ್ ಎಮ್ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ಇದೆ. ನಮ್ಮ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ಇಂದ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಬಟ್ ಟಾಟಾ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ಸ್ ಇಂದ ಸ್ಕಾಲರ್ಶಿಪ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ ಎಮ್ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ. ಎಷ್ಟೊಂದ್ ಜನ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ನಮ್ಮ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಗೆ ಸ್ಕಾಲರ್ಶಿಪ್ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿದೆ ಎಮ್ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ, ಬಟ್ ಬ್ಯಾಚುಲರ್ಸ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಕಾಲರ್ಶಿಪ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಸದ್ಯಕ್ಕೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಏನಾದ್ರೂ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ತೋರಿಸದೆ ಹೋದ್ರು ಆಮೇಲೆ ಅಕಸ್ಮಾತ್ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಹೊಳದ್ರೆ, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಲೇಟರ್, ಖಂಡಿತ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಇಮೇಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ಅಥವಾ ಫೋನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ಅಥವಾ ನಮ್ಮ ವೆಬ್ಸೈಟ್ಗೆ ವಿಸಿಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ನೀವು ತಿಳ್ಕೊಬೋದು. ಸೊ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಡೀಟೇಲ್ಸ್ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದೀನಿ, ಇಮೇಲು, ವೆಬ್ಸೈಟು, ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ಫೋನ್ ನಂಬರ್. ಇನ್ನೊಂದ್ಸಲಿ ಯಾರಿಗಾದ್ರೂ ಬೇಕಿದ್ರೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದ್ಸಲಿ ಅದು ಆ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ಹಾಕ್ಬಿಡ್ತೀನಿ. ನಮ್ಮ ಫೋನ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಇದೆ, ಇಮೇಲ್ ಇದೆ, ಮತ್ತೆ ವೆಬ್ಸೈಟು ಇದೆ. ಸೊ ಎಲ್ಲ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ವೆಬ್ಸೈಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲೇ ಸಿಗತ್ತೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ. ಬಟ್ ಅದ್ರ ಆದ್ಮೇಲೂ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಡೌಟ್ ಏನಾದ್ರೂ ಇದ್ರೆ ಖಂಡಿತ ನಮ್ಮ ಆಫೀಸ್ಗೆ ಕಾಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ಅಥವಾ ನಮ್ಗೊಂದು ಇಮೇಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು.
ಹಲೋ ಸರ್. ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಟೇಶನ್ ಫೆಸಿಲಿಟೀಸ್ ಏನಿದೆ ಸರ್ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ಗೆ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ?
ವಿತಿನ್ ಮೈಸೂರ?
ಹಾ ಹೌದು ಸರ್, ಜೆ ಪಿ ನಗರ್.
ನಮ್ದು ವ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಂತ ಇಲ್ಲ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್. ಸೊ ಯೂಶಲಿ ವಿತಿನ್ ಮೈಸೂರ್ ನಮ್ದು ಅದು ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಫೆಸಿಲಿಟಿ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಬಟ್ ಮೆಡಿಕಲ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸಿಗಿದೆ. ಸೊ ಅಕಸ್ಮಾತ್ ಇಫ್ ನೆಸೆಸರಿ ನಾವು ಅದು ಅರೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು.
ಸೊ ಈ ಕಾಲೇಜಿಗೆ ಸೆಪರೇಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಟೇಶನ್ ಫೆಸಿಲಿಟೀಸ್ ಇಟ್ಟಿಲ್ಲ?
ಹಾ, ಇಟ್ಟಿಲ್ಲ. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಸದ್ಯಕ್ಕೆ ಯಾರು ಹತ್ರ ಕೇಳಿಲ್ಲ ನಮ್ನ. ಮೈಸೂರಲ್ಲಿ ಇರೋರೆಲ್ಲ ಅವ್ರದೇ ವೆಹಿಕಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ ಅಥವಾ ಹಾಸ್ಟೆಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ, ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ತುಂಬಾ ಬೇಗ ನಡ್ಕೊಂಡ್ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಡ್ಬೋದು ಹಾಸ್ಟೆಲ್ ಇಂದ. ಸೊ ಅದು ಸದ್ಯಕ್ಕೆ ನಮ್ಗೆ ನೀಡ್ ಕಂಡು ಬಂದಿಲ್ಲ, ಅದರಿಂದ ಮಾಡಿಲ್ಲ. ಬಟ್ ತುಂಬಾ ಜನ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ಅರೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು, ಯಾಕೆಂದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ದು ವ್ಯಾನ್ ಇದೆ ನಮ್ ಸ್ಪೀಚ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಹಿಯರಿಂಗ್. ಬಟ್ ಇನ್ನು ಅದ್ ಯಾರು ಕೇಳಿಲ್ಲ, ಅದರಿಂದ ನಾವು ಇಟ್ಟಿಲ್ಲ ಅಷ್ಟೇ.
ಓಕೆ, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸರ್.
Okay. So thank you everyone for attending the webinar. As always, we are always open. So any doubts idru kandita namna kelbodu. Thank you. We'll be ending the meeting here.